Hello, we're going to be reviewing Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. I went ahead and underlined it with the blue of the Bible Reading Journal Series color chart. I want to be in obedience. I want to pay close attention to what the Holy Spirit is telling me to do as I read the verse. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works. That's a command right there. And he wants for us to be obedient, which God prepared in advance for us to do. So let's go ahead and review a little bit today's little Bible lesson. And the Bible lesson is coming from this reference, 52 Weeks with Jesus, Fall in Love with the Other, One Who Changed Everything by James Merritt. And let's just quickly review this one titled, Just Like Us. The reason you are who you are. What do you do when God falls silent? That's the question Jewish people were asking during the 400 years before Jesus' birth. For centuries, God spoke to his people, but when the last prophet, Malachi, wrote his final words and put down his pen, God stopped talking. For nearly half a millennium, they heard neither godly grunt nor heavenly hiccup, only silence. When God finally began talking again, the first thing he had someone jot down was a family tree. You may be tempted to skip the genealogy at the front of your New Testament. Who wants to come through the names of strangers giving birth to strangers? But you dare not. Why? Because this family tree is yours and mine. Imagine if a distant relative told you they had located a family tree that traced your lineage more than 2,000 years. I would be quite excited, my friends. You wouldn't wait for a coffee break to read it. No, you would snatch that sucker up and study it, even if you had to use a vacation day at work. I think I would. The genealogies in the Bible are worth our time because they tell stories of how God has moved in the life of your ancestor for millennia. And the reason you are who you are. That's exciting. And more to the point of this journey, they tell us about a lot about our older brother, Jesus. You're in the picture. God could have just left Jesus on someone's doorstep, but instead he did it through the mosaic of ordinary humans. Why did God use all these people in Jesus' family tree? It has been noted that as few as 5 points of identification can single out any individual from the billions of other people on the planet. Name, street, address, city, state, and nation of residence. If someone anywhere in the world were to write those indicators down, they could locate you. Just as Jesus Christ has certain markers that identify him as the Messiah. Thank you, Jesus. You are and I were born with certain signs chosen by God so that we could fit into his plan. Thank you, Jesus. God wants our lives to be a masterpiece of his goodness and grace. And that's when Ephesians 2:10 comes in. Jesus was just like us, born with a past and history, and we have been made to become like him. God wants you to be a masterpiece of his grace by living for his glory and expressing his goodness to others. Oh my goodness, I love this prayer before we go ahead and review my journaling. Lord, thank you for including me in the rich lineage, which has made me a member of your family. It's a royal family indeed. Equip me to share your goodness so that more can be called your children. So let's take a look at my journaling, what I did this week. And basically, I went ahead and translated the same verse in 2 different translations, the Amplified Bible. I underlined it or highlighted it in blue, which is for obedience, to remind me that we are his workmanship, his own master work and work of art, created in Christ Jesus, reborn from above, spiritually transformed, renewed, and ready to be used. Yes, my friend, we all want to be ready to be used by him. Lord, help me step out in obedience by continuing learning and becoming more like you, like Jesus, and loving people, those people that I dislike. Yes, I do dislike some people, but he wants for us to love everyone, all of our neighbors and people that we know. Lord, I would like to share and repent that my tendency is to quickly react on things. It's always great to be able to repent of any unconfessed sins. Then gratitude, I counted all of my blessings. And then I went ahead and prayed over protection for all my family and friends here in Florida and internationally for them to be protected from COVID-19 as we move forward with our lives and take more calculated risks. And then I went ahead and inscribed a few other scriptures, including Ephesians 2, verse 16 and 13, Ephesians 4, verse 24, and Galatians 3:10 by the Amplified Bible. And I like how the Galatians 3:10 said, and put on the new spiritual self who's been continually renewed in true knowledge in the image of him who created the new self. And that is my ongoing prayer as I renew my mind every morning and bring my petitions to our beloved Jesus and confess and pray and so forth. So you all have a blessed day, my friend.